Hey everyone, I'm Thomas from Backscatter, and today we're diving into the Backscatter fluorescence system for the hybrid flash and macro wide 4300 video light. Did you ever have a black light poster in your dorm room? If you're into those wild colors and want a fresh take on photography and video, then fluorescence is for you. Shooting fluorescence is a great creative outlet for both photo and video. Fluoro images and video have a unique look, making uninteresting subjects look bold and vivid. This trippy effect is a great way to play with a brand new color palette that just isn't available with normal white light. In this video, we'll cover what fluorescence is, why it's awesome, the gear you need, and how to get the best shots. So let's jump in and check it out. Fluorescence happens when a subject absorbs light at one wavelength and emits it back at a different color, which is bright, neon-looking, and extremely vivid. Some green plants and algae, for example, will glow bright red when fluorescing. This isn't the same as bioluminescence, which is a chemical reaction that creates its own light. Think of a glow stick versus a blacklight poster. Fluorescence is best captured in dark conditions and easiest seen at night. Whether you're shooting with a GoPro, a compact camera like a TG7, or an advanced interchangeable lens system, capturing fluorescence is easy. Even if you're not a photographer, fluoro night diving is a ton of fun and you never know it might glow. To see fluorescence, you need two key tools. The first thing you'll need is a blue excitation filter for your light or flash. This will transform the light into the wavelength needed to make subjects glow. The next item you'll need is a yellow barrier filter. This blocks out the blue light so only fluorescence is visible. The Backscatter fluorescence excitation filters attach easily to the hybrid flash and macro wide 4300 video light, eliminating the need for a separate blue light. The excitation filter for the hybrid flash uses the same bayonet mounting system as the diffusers. Just line it up and rotate it into place. The excitation filter for the macro wide 4300 light simply presses to the front of the light and will snap on, just like the color filter holder. Since the hybrid flash is both a strobe and a video light, the built-in LEDs can help locate subjects and record video, while its powerful flash can capture still images. The macro wide 4300's bright, concentrated spot beam makes it perfect for macro fluoro video. The Backscatter Mini Flash 2 can use the same excitation filters as the macro wide 4300, but it is a less powerful flash by design, making the hybrid flash a better choice for most subjects because of its powerful flash beam. Yellow barrier filters come in three different versions. The 67mm is used with most ports and external wet lenses with 67mm threads, while the 52mm version attaches to 52mm OM System TG series housings. The flip filter version attaches to GoPro housings using the flip filter frame. To spot fluorescent subjects more easily, use the Backscatter Dive Mask Barrier Filter. The included strap allows you to flip it down while searching for subjects and flip it up when you're looking through your viewfinder or monitor. Fluorescence is a weak effect, so here's some quick tips to maximize the fluoro effect. Use a close focusing macro lens to get as close to the subject as possible. For aperture, open it up to f8 or f11 to let in more light and maintain a good depth of field. You will also be using higher ISOs than normal. ISO of 400 to 800 can be used for corals and anemones since they tend to glow brighter, and ISO 1600 to 3200 will be used for subjects with eyes like fish since they tend to glow a bit less bright. You'll want to set your white balance to a fixed value of 5500 Kelvin for consistent color between all your photos and video. For video, we'll need to consider shutter speed and frame rate and higher ISOs as well. Set your frame rate to 30 frames per second and shutter speed to 1/30th to let more light in. expect to use high ISOs such as 10,000 as well. Video lights are a lot less bright than strobes, and they'll need all the help they can get. Make sure to position your lighting close and use high power output to get the best result for fluoro photos and video. Fluorescence photography is an easy way to get wild, creative shots while having a ton of fun in the process. Check out our fluoro reel and article link below for more examples. And if you have any questions, give us a call or send us an email. Remember, your purchases from Backscatter or any of our authorized dealers help us keep making more of these videos. We have free lifetime tech support on every purchase, and we dive, shoot, and service everything that we sell. I'm Thomas from Backscatter, and I'll see you next time.